Hi, I'm Raj Sodhi, marketing engineer for Keysight Technologies High Performance Signal Analyzer. I'm excited to show you our new 1 GHz analysis bandwidth solution integrated in our UXA signal analyzer. A radar engineer can now capture a wider spectrum of the electronic battlefield, enabling more accurate pulse characterization and radar system interaction measurements. Engineering is all about connecting ideas and solving problems. This experience drives the X-Series signal analyzers, the benchmark for accessible performance that puts you closer to the answer by easily linking cause and effect. Over the past 50 years, analyzers have evolved from the swept-tuned spectrum analyzers of the 60s to vector signal analyzers of the 90s to real-time spectrum analyzers with ever wider bandwidth. With the arrival of 802.11ac, it became necessary to run tests at 160 MHz bandwidth about an RF carrier. DOCSIS 3.1 pushed this envelope even further. In aerospace defense, there is an ever-increasing need for analyzing significantly wider bandwidths. Shown here is a 1 GHz wide chirp centered at 10 GHz. In the past, we met this requirement using a two-box solution and the 89600 VSA software. Let me show you how we can do this using the one-box UXA. In setting up a realistic signal, I will use the multi-emitter scenario generation software in combination with the UXG Agile Signal Generator. Using two emitters from a common platform, it's straightforward to set up interleaved pulses, where one pulse has a stepped frequency from negative 100 MHz to 100 MHz, and the other is a chirped FM signal ranging from negative 400 MHz to plus 400 MHz. Looking at our signal in swept mode, we see lots of spectral content covering the middle 800 MHz of our span. Switching over to the real-time spectrum analyzer, we get a closer look at what's going on. Here we see the stepped frequencies of the first emitter ranging from negative 100 MHz to plus 100 MHz. We also see the enormous FM chirp in the background, spanning 800 MHz, filling up the entire viewable span of 500 MHz. We may view the signal in a power versus time graph. We also see a spectrogram or waterfall plot along the left and a spectrum plot along the bottom. These are all being updated in real time. You may immediately notice two things. The span has been reduced to 255 MHz, and the pulses are not stable versus time. For power versus time, the maximum span is 255 MHz, which might explain the funny nature of that taller pulse. Don't forget, we are looking at a chirped signal that is being chirped across 800 MHz, so we are seeing fragments when the signal goes in and out of our viewing bandwidth. We may stabilize the power versus time graph by switching the trigger from free run to level trigger, and then set the trigger level to a salient power like negative 5 dBm. Alternatively, we may leave the trigger level to a lower power like negative 30 dBm and take advantage of time-qualified triggering. This enables us to trigger when the power versus time has met certain criteria. Since we know the first pulse is 10 microseconds wide, we will trigger when the power exceeds the power threshold for more than 7.5 microseconds, and less than 15 microseconds. As you can see, this also works very well. Let's analyze these pulses using the pulse measurement application. Using the level trigger, we are able to stabilize these pulses in the time domain. Here we show amplitude versus time, a table of relevant figures of merit, instantaneous frequency deviation versus time, and instantaneous phase versus time. All of these are updated in real time. Numerous other quantities may be selected for plotting or for tabulation in a pulse table. Note that the slope of FM deviation is correct, 40 MHz per microsecond. And if you consider that the pulse width is 20 microseconds, the chirp will eventually span 800 MHz. But also notice that the peak-to-peak deviation is only represented as 382 MHz. Clearly, with only 510 MHz, we don't have the bandwidth we need. The chirp signal is going in and out of our analysis bandwidth. Using the UXA with 1 GHz analysis bandwidth in combination with the 89600 VSA software, we are able to view and analyze the entire signal spectrum. The leftmost graph shows pulse envelope amplitude versus time. We observe a 10 dB difference in amplitude between the interleaved pulses, and we expected this. We also see amplitude variation across the wideband chirp. This is further blown up in the rightmost graph as we measure the properties of a single chirp. Overlaid here is our familiar linear frequency deviation as well as parabolic instantaneous phase. The middle graph shows the full spectrum of our 1 GHz analysis solution. Here we can see the stepped frequencies of the first emitter as well as the enormous bandwidth of the second emitter. Note that we are only tabulating the figures of merit associated with the chirp signal. We may economically represent this train of pulses using pulsed descriptor words, or PDWs for short. The result is a CSV file that may be imported to a UXG agile signal generator. In this video, we set up a very wideband pulsed radar scenario and then analyzed it with the UXA's integrated 1 GHz bandwidth. This works well with the pulse measurement application and the 89600 VSA software. With the UXA, you have the highest performance, widest bandwidth analyzer on the market today that lets you see the real performance of your device, reducing the cost and hassle of using large, complicated test systems. Let me invite you to see more and take your designs farther with the X-Series UXA signal analyzer, now with an integrated 1 GHz bandwidth. Please contact your Keysight sales representative for more details or even for a live demonstration. Thanks so much.